Well, you've seen it on the show. Bars have always been a difficult business, but staying afloat is now a whole different ballgame with COVID-19. And there is no one better to talk to about this than John Taffer. He is the host of Bar Rescue, and he's a Las Vegas local, joining us live from his home this morning. John, good morning to you. We are such big fans of the show. It's great to have you.
Good morning. Good to be here.
So, John, Governor Sisolak ordered bars that do not serve food to close again this past weekend. You know, some didn't make it through the first closure just a few months ago. How difficult will it be for the second one?
Oh, it's going to be devastating. But you know what concerns me is bars and restaurants have the same air conditioning systems with the same airflow. They have the same density inside the rooms. If they're both at 50% capacity and there's the same amount of distance between guests and guests are wearing masks, I personally don't understand the difference between a bar and a restaurant. And that concerns me that the two are being treated so differently. In a restaurant environment, you can't walk up to the bar. I get that, of course. There's spacing. People need to be seated. You'd think the same policies could carry through for a bar that carry through for a restaurant. And that's what concerns me. I'm not certain a lot of these bars will survive this.
Well, and John, we've heard so many bar owners have that same concern. They've spent thousands of dollars on meeting these CDC guidelines while they were closed and not making any money. What's the financial impact on that? It's been devastating already.
Well, you know, the problem is that all of the COVID-related activities cost money, whether it's PPE or disposable glassware or cleaning supplies and chemicals. So we've added expenses and we've cut revenues by 70, 80, in some cases 90, 100%. Businesses can't survive without revenue. Revenue cures everything. You know, my rent isn't high. When my revenues are high, I can afford everything. So I'm very, very concerned that if we don't come up with a plan for restaurants and bars collectively and quickly to create some cash flow, that without the revenues, there is no room for recovery. And that's what my concern is.
What would you suggest bar owners do during this time while they are forced to be closed? Is there anything they can do to ensure that they do reopen?
Yeah, you know, it's very difficult to operate a business without revenue. So, you know, dare I say, in many cases, I think the bar should close. And I think they should wait it out, try to negotiate deals with landlords, rent abatements, things like that, to try to survive during this period. It's going to be impossible to be profitable now. So if I'm going to bleed money, then let me bleed less money. Let me know how much money I'm going to bleed each month while I'm closed, and let me keep my resources so I can open when the pandemic is over. And that's what I'm concerned about. We here in Las Vegas need to be able to reopen, to accommodate all of our guests as an American destination. If we expend all of our resources now, many of these independent operations won't have the resources to reopen. So do I spend it now when I can't make money, or do I wait and spend it later when I can make money? That's the dilemma.
And I think a lot of bar owners were holding on for so many months, and they were so excited to finally get back open in some capacity. They thought they made it through. Now you have this second wave. John, how long do you think it'll take for us to rebound here in Las Vegas?
Well, I'm very concerned. Obviously, our numbers aren't good right now, and nationally, the numbers don't seem to be so strong either. You know, the first time in this, we figured we'd be out in a couple of months. The second time has been much more emotionally devastating. Now we're not sure. Is this 3 months, 4 months, 2 months, 6 months? Does this run to the end of the year? So we've sort of lost the light at the end of the tunnel on this second blow, and I'm very concerned about the emotional state of business owners right now.
Really quickly, John, I want to ask you, I know there's a lot of changes and hopefully things will get back to normal at some point. When they do, what do you think bars will look like in the future?
Well, you know, it depends upon what the future is. I personally believe we'll have vaccines by 21. I sit on a board of a hospital, so I do have some good information. I'm very confident that in 2021, things start to normalize again. When that happens and we have a vaccine, I'm one of those people who think it goes back to normal. And we've seen it these past couple months. Think about this. While the pandemic was still going, people packed into bars, people packed into other tourist destinations. So we're seeing people's desire to come back. We just have to create the safety to do so. And it's not on the industry. We've done everything right here in Las Vegas. 800 new procedures in casinos, bars, restaurants. We've done it right as operators. Now medical science needs to create the environment that we can all come back.
Yeah, and we feel for everyone who's just trying to hold on. John Taffer, it is so great to get your perspective. We appreciate you, and catch John Taffer on Bar Rescue. Thank you so much, sir.
Bye-bye.
Bye.